you listen to this, bear in mind that Peter is completely blind and has been since birth, plays all the instruments himself, he sings himself, and he writes the music as well. What an incredible talent he is. He's brought out a brand new album for Christmas in winter 2017. And on that we're going to play this track, which is all we've done now, if you know what this is all about. The track is called Hygge. And if you're not sure what Hygge is, it's the general feeling of well-being that is used in Denmark. This is absolutely beautiful. It's a long track for sure as well. Not for my name is Tom Rock, so, but for sure though, it's a long track. And
radio waves here on the free radio service panel. Nothing will take you back to Christmas 1965. Big L on the Galaxy, Radio London with Tony Windsor, Paul Kay, Mike Lennox and Dave Cash. Getting a little bit tipsy, I think, and having a bit of a sing of some carols as well.
FRS goes back in time. This is a flashback.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, ladies and gentlemen.
We have a beer and better Jerry, but Dave gets it the best we can get this year. Business is not as good as usual, but it's certainly going well with our talking books to the plant. We are going to sing. How many seconds? 10 seconds. Oh, Dave gets using his natural voice at this Christmas. Marvelous. Absolutely marvelous.
10 seconds.
That's better, yes.
Five.
Make the professional.
Yeah, here we go.
It's Christmas Day, ladies and gentlemen. Merry Christmas.
Radio Wave on FRS Holland.
And we'll finish off with a little bit of a froggy Christmas theme for you right here on the free radio service Holland. the very proggy Christmas, and that was called Frankenstein. So almost it from me for today, coming in next on the free radio service holiday it is Peter Verbruggen, FRS Goes to Xmas. Thank you very, very much indeed for your company today. It's been a pleasure being with you right here on the free radio service Holland, but I will be back in 2018. In the meantime, keep it right here on shortwave on FRS Holland. It reads like an adventurous voice book. Caroline's 50 plus year history. A complete new and perhaps unexpected next chapter was added last August. It was already in 2010 that Bob Lawrence suggested to the regulator Ofcom in the UK that as radio stations in the UK felt little interest in their AM services, now huge harm could be done by giving Caroline a frequency to use. He was told that there was no procedure by which this could be done, and that in any case there were no spare frequencies. However, on May 17th of this year, Ofcom announced that an AM license would be awarded to cover Sussex and North Essex. In its application, Radio Caroline had asked for 1 kilowatt of power compared to the usual 50 watts that community services operate at. The station's application said it would broadcast most of the program from Kent and from the Lockley Vent using 4G. Ofcom noted that the application was from a well-established group with a long history of providing a radio service and was satisfied that it had demonstrated its ability to maintain a service. Ofcom considered that the service would broaden choice in relation to existing radio services available with a strong urban focus. Caroline stated that the basis of the station was their traditional heartland, North Essex and Sussex, where the signal from the Caroline ship made first landfall, and they wished to entertain on AM, an audience that they have not been able to serve in this way since the early 90s. The station, which began in 1964, was desperate to be on the air this year, as it is 50 years since the 1967 Marine Broadcasting Offensive Act that was intended to shepherd the pirate broadcasters. After the MOA had passed in 1967, Radio Caroline continued to broadcast until the Rocky Bank was shipwrecked off the Kent coast in 1991. Radio Caroline had been operating as an internet and digital radio station in recent years. Last August, Caroline announced that its new AM frequency would be 648 kHz, which is 460 meters, with a power of 1000 watts TRP, which is the actual power radiated by the aerial. A transmitter was imported from the continent and has been modified ever since to suit the frequency. Quite unexpectedly, the transmission started from the transmitting site Orfordness on Saturday, November 11th at 10:45 a.m. Central European Time. So far, excellent reception.
Noted within Caroline's target area,
while reports from abroad came from as far as Finland and Italy. Reception during daytime proved to be good in large parts of the Netherlands, Belgium, and French coastal areas as well. But also in Ireland, Caroline was monitored, and in Kent and London, there was good reception too. Even in the south of the Netherlands, it was 8.3 hertz of power radio. Reception during evening, and at 9:30 another story.
are at site houses 3 and Banner 15, formerly used by the BBC World Service. The 648 tower, used for reserve, which is now the Caroline Tower, is having a height of no less than 350 feet, which is the equivalent of nearly 107 meters. It was built back in 1983, the same year Caroline returned on 319 from the Rock Revenge. It serviced until 2011, now nearly 7 years ago. On the Caroline website, Alan Beach has researched the fascinating history of 648 AM within the UK, being a very interesting and lengthy article. Talks have been ongoing for some time between the Caroline organization and Cobra Mist Limited, who own the transmission site. The first series of tests was run till November 13th, and following a temporarily stop, tests were resumed during the final November weekend. A reception report roundup can be found at www.scoutradiocaroline.co.uk. Caroline uses a brand new state-of-the-art DSTX digital audio processor supplied by Broadcast Warehouse. On good quality radios, many accept that the station sounds very bright. Many Caroline supporters are eagerly awaiting the official start on 648. Rumors have it that moment will be this very weekend. Who knows? Moving on with the next item, thank you to David Williams, Christian Muller, and to Raymond Schneider from Germany for your Christmas card, which we received just in time to read out in FRS.gx. If you are interested to watch the All Fitness site on YouTube, there are a few interesting videos. Former Radio Netherlands World Service Media Network anchorman Jonathan Mars shot a 17-minute video in excellent quality. Use the keyword farewell to BBC 648 kHz. Another much shorter one features the end of BBC World Service on 648, and the third one is entitled BBC High Frequency Transmitter Station, All Fitness. Since June 3rd, the radio vessel Rock Revenge has officially become a historic ship. The independent organization National Historic Ships UK has adopted the Rock Revenge in the National Register of Historic Vessels of the United Kingdom. And finally, Radio Caroline North returns this very weekend for their final broadcast of 2017. They'll be broadcasting live from the Rock Revenge on River Blackwater on 1368 AM, courtesy of Manx Radio. Transmissions are also online. Emails are always welcome at memories@radiocaroline.co.uk. It is remarkable how many new Oxford radio-related books have been published in recent years. Many of them have been passing a review in FRS.gx. Recently, two new books were presented, both having a clear link to former Dutch Oxford pioneer Radio Veronica. It was 50 years ago that former Veronica group Lex Harding presented his very first radio show. Last November, his book in which he looked back at an impressive radio career through 70 unforgettable songs. Harding's debut was in 1967 on Radio Dolphin. In the end, he became the most popular Dutch DJ, presenting his daily Veronica show Lectio and in Veronica for 40 every Saturday afternoon. In the book, including 4 CDs, he describes his favorite songs plus his radio and TV highlights and anecdotes. It's an emotional and nostalgic trip. The hardcover book plus CD costs 14 euro and can be ordered via several Dutch internet shops, but also via Amazon.co.uk. November 20th, a special book was launched entitled How Thor Turned a Ship. Former Veronica employee, journalist Hans Becker composed the book full of memories and more than 300 photos, including the dramatic moments the Northern Ace stranded on the Scheveningen beach in 1973. 70-year-old Becker worked in the 1970 to 1974 period as presenter and editor of Veronica's pop journal. The aforementioned period had never been published before and tell the story how life was aboard a ship on the North Sea and in the Hudson. Relatively new book, Offshore Radio Engineering 2017, updated edition by Jan Zimmerman, 83 pages. Later radio programming by Paul Rutland. Life on the North Sea by Stuart Simpson, 167 pages. And my memory of a dual old lady by Heather Booth, 173 pages. For all of the books, visit www.bobleroy.co.uk, you'll find an updated website. 2014 saw part one of the trilogy, Life and Death of a Pirate. Over 3 years later, all three parts of the personal life of Reginald, Elbert and his family. Life in the music industry, and not to forget his involvement in the Oscar radio world. In the first half of the 1960s, Stephen Moore, Reginald and Dorothy Selwood's daughter, and wrote the trilogy of Reginald. And 300 pages are dedicated to Radio Texas and Radio City's history in part 2 and 3 of the book. The hardcover book contains no less than 474 pages with numerous photos. Within the UK, they will cost £18.50, including postage and package. For more info, search to www.rocksilver.co.uk. Move on with more The Ethnic. Some 70 minutes to go before it's 1 o'clock on the Torres band. Reception report and personal letters are more than welcome. Some personal comments are more than appreciated. Box C702 in 6049 ZB Hexton in the Netherlands. And there is a brand new CDL card waiting for you. That's number 9 in our series, Adel Holland Trilogy. That one is now printed in large format, full color, on quality paper. For €3 or $3, you'll get that CDL card if you send the correct reception box, along with a large ticket and, of course, a personal reply. In particular, but also non-German ones, accident information which are the medium ways and surveys, we can recommend the old reactor. There is no better in the German area. Look at the internet at www.ratcr.at and consider to become a member. Do not leave your main private email address, because you will get around 10 emails or more every day from the actors all over the place, unless you like it. Use an alternative such as Microsoft or a Google account. For receiving exceptional stations, you have to be a real hunter. Best time to listen to me relay is this moment around 16:30 and around 800 hours until noon time. Always if the sun goes up or down in your area. Watch a certain frequency for some time and suddenly you might get an amazing signal from perhaps far away. It is different as listening to shortwave. The signals are coming in and disappearing on a certain frequency. The internet provides lots of interesting background information about radio wave reacting. For instance, at www.nwcircle.org or https://radiowave.info. There are fears. The famous Red Sandport, located in the same estuary between Kent and Essex, could disappear altogether if funding isn't promptly repaired. More than £3 million is needed to restore them. An interview with David Phillips from Project Red Sand is to be read at familiar Oscar radio jingles have been produced by Stan Justice. Examples are the R&I Dynamite set from 1973, but also Radio Atlantis and Caroline jingles. Stan Justice was vice president of famous Dallas-based CM Productions. also a great vinyl enthusiast and a Tomahawk specialist. He became familiar with the offshore phenomenon because of his friendship with Steve England. Here are a few examples of Ken Justice predictions from the 1970s. We start with some sad news regarding the well-known Fender und Frequenzen yearbook. In the past years, this very informative book was reviewed in the December edition of Everest South the Exmus. This year is down, as Fender und Frequenzen has been discontinued for economic reasons. Less tour weight listeners, less sales. The 2017 edition, which came out in late 2016, a year ago, was the last book of their series to be published after 34 years. This must be bad news for serious hardcore directors. Luckily, the CMC 2018 tour weight continues. No review, but instead the website with very detailed information. www.cleanandfood.org/fws.htm. Have a look, it's worthwhile. To fail in recent weeks. We are now in a period that winter conditions rule the airwaves with stronger signals during daytime and poorer reception throughout the evening. There was not that much activity on the shortwave bands in recent weeks. The best 20 web receiver remains very popular. Another good source is SiriusXVR at SiriusXVR.com. And you can also hear many free radio systems from Europe via the internet at loud.fm/jukebox. If you are an operator of a shortwave freeway station and you're looking for a reliable postal address, please contact us at PO Box 2702-6049, that's the Hudson, the Netherlands. Or, of course, via address at address.com. Before moving on with a number of shortwave topics, I'd like to draw your attention to the subject of listener revolt. Unfortunately, a recurring subject, because it happens to us too often that we receive incomplete and poor quality reports. And that's not that we cannot ignore such reports here in America. We feel that reports can only be with one of our teams out when certain standards are met, including date and time, preferably during a period of 20 to 30 minutes. Your receiver antenna is looking to a number of details, not just amounts of a passenger, but many departures or evaluating the signal's quality. Now, when sending an anti-phone file, it will be much appreciated when listeners add date and time of reception, PPH and frequency in the title of the MP3. Even when you send in a MP3 file. At present time, time, the following stations are using the Hexing Bank Steelbook 2702 mail drop service. Skyline Radio from Germany. Radio Border Hunter from the Netherlands. Radio Space Shuttle. Thermal Radio Blue Star, nowadays using different names. And newcomer, XTC Radio from the UK. An item which is not often part of Everest Gulf yet, called Waking Teasers. Several well-known receivers from the past are no longer available, but the market is interesting receivers, like for instance, several key models. Satellite radio, the SES 2001D, or the well-known LOW-125 from the UK. All radios have a higher than average sensitivity and various other interesting options. There are several sites which cover those receivers. An excellent site for details of service is one run by Apple, where you can also own contact for Apple. It is a US-based site, so you may find more things of the receiver, which are available in the UK and or in Europe. But if you visit eBay, you can find many of these 1990s storage receivers. The address of the US site is https://fwlink.com/blog/shortwave/radio-review. But there are many more interesting sites as well. An alternative to use a web-based receiver. There are a few interesting sites which were already mentioned in previous editions of Everest Dog Yet. A second interesting alternative is a so-called soft-defined receiver, usually operated on your personal computer. An exception is the Sum Radio CR-1A, which is independent of a host PC, using embedded digital signal processing technology. By the way, I should also mention the Zenzen LQS-900X, which is still available these days. Transmitting location is in Lower Germany, in accordance with the license issued by the German Federal Net Agency. The website name